Hi children, this is your ANR sir with a new lesson on square roots and cube roots. Your question reads like this: which smallest number must be added to 2203 to get a perfect square? Let me read the question again. Which smallest number must be added to 2203 to get a perfect square? So if this type of a question is given, that means what smallest number is to be added if this is given, then we should find the square root of the given number by long division method. So let us do the square root of this number by long division method. Clear? So here 22 is there. So what is our table? 1 1s are 1, 2 2s are 4, 3 3s are 9, 4 4s are 16, 5 5s are 25. 5 5s are won't go. So 4 4s are 16. What is the remainder? 12 minus 6, 6, 0, 3. Here you have to take 4, add 8. So here some number you should write, and with that you have to multiply this whole number. So what would be that number? 8, 7, how much? 56. Let us try. 8, 7, 7. 7, 7, 49, 4, and 50, 6 plus 4, 60. Clear? So it won't go. So what you get? 609. So here if in place of 6, if you have 9, in place of 6, if you have 9, then it will become a perfect square number. What is asked? What smallest number must be added? That means how much you have to add for this 3 to get 9? 6. What is to be added? 6 is to be added. So 6 is to be added to make what? 2203 a perfect square. Clear? So what is our answer? 6. So your C is the required answer. I think you understood how to solve this type of a question. So now your next question reads like this: what is the smallest positive integer which when multiplied by 392 gives a perfect square? Let me read. What is the smallest positive integer which when multiplied by 392 gives a perfect square? So here what is given? Multiplied is given. What is given? Multiplied. If multiplied is given, then we should find the factors of 392. Understood? When this multiplied is given, then we should find the factors of 392. This question is given in SSC 2005. Let us find the factors of 392. So 392, 9 plus 5, 14, not divisible by 3. So let us do with 2. 2 ones are 2, 19, 2 nines are 18, 6. Clear? Again, 2. 2 into 2 into 2 nines are and 2 eights are. 2 into 2 into, again let us do with 2. 4 are and 9 are. 49 means 7, 7 jar. See, to find to make this a perfect square, these two pair of twos are there, pair of sevens are there. For these two, you do not have another pair. You do not have another pair for this two. So, if you multiply this number by 2, then this number would become a perfect square. So, what is the least number that is to be multiplied with this to make this a perfect square? 2. So, here your A is the right answer. I think you understood how to solve this type of a question. So, your next sum reads like this. The least number to be subtracted from 16,800 to make it a perfect square is. Let me repeat. The least number to be subtracted. It may be added or subtracted. We should do long division method. So, let us find the square root of 16800 by long division method. 16800. So, 1 1 jar 1. 6 8. Here what we added? 1. So, 2. Here you should write something, with that you have to multiply. Clear? So, what you write here? If you write 3, 3 3 is 9, 6. Clear? But here you have 68 only, so you cannot take 3, 2. 2. So, 44. 8 minus 4, 4. 6 minus 4, 2, and 2 zeros, 2 zeros, here you have to add 2, 24, 24, so how many times it will go? 2, 4, 8, that's 5, 8 is 64, 6, 32 plus 6, 38, 3, 16 plus 3, 19, 8 is up. Clear? 1, 9, 8, 4. Let us write 9, 9, 9 is up, 81, 8, 36, 8, 44, 4, 18, 22, 9 will go. How much? 4, 1. So, 9, and here 9 minus 4, 5, 3 minus 2, 1. So, what number is to be subtracted he is giving? What he has given? What number has to be subtracted to make this number a perfect square? So, we should subtract 159. If we subtract from this number 159, whatever the number will be left, that would become a perfect square. So, your answer is B. I think you understood. If we subtract this number 159 from this, then this will become a perfect square. So, how much is to be subtracted? 159. So, your next question reads like this. 3 root 2 by root 3 plus root 6 minus 4 root 3 by root 6 plus root 2 plus root 6 by root 2 plus root 3 is equal to what? So what we have to do, let us simplify each. If this is given, what we need to do, we need to multiply both numerator and denominator by root 3 minus root 6 minus root 3. Root 6 minus root 3 by root 6 minus root 3. Your denominator is in the form of a plus b into a minus b. A plus b into a minus b. That means a plus b into a minus b is equal to a square minus b square. A square means what? 6. Minus b square means what? 3. So here 3 root 2 into root 6 minus root 3. And 6 minus 3 is equal to 3. This 3 and this 3 cancels. Clear? So, 2 root 6 minus root 2 root 3. Or, here you can break this. 2 into 3. Root 2 into root 3. Root 2 into root 2. 2. So this will become 2 root 3 minus, this is root 2 root 3 means what? Root 6. Root 6. So we keep it here. Now we simplify the second term. 4 root 3 by root 6 plus root 2. That means we multiply by root 6 minus root 2 minus root 6 minus root 2. A plus b into a minus b. A square minus b square minus 6 minus 2. And here 4 root 3 into root 6 minus root 2. 4 minus 2. 6 minus 2, 4, and this 4 cancels. Clear? And this again, this root 6 we break into root 2 into root 3. Root 3 into root 3, 3. 3 root 2 minus root 3 into root 2, root 6. Let us keep here. Clear? Now, let us simplify the third term. 3rd term, root 6 by root 2 plus root 3. Then we multiply by root 3 minus root 2. Root 3 minus root 2. That means 3 minus 2, 1. Clear? And here root 6 into root 3 minus root 2. Root 6 into root 3. That means root 18. Root 18 means what? 2 into 9, that means 9 is 3, 3 root 2, minus root 2 root 2, root 12, root 12 means what? 4 into root 3, that means 2 root 3. So let us take this minus this, that means 2 root 3 minus root 6 minus 3 root 2 plus root 6 plus 3 root 2 minus 2 root 3. Root 6 cancelled. Minus 3 root 2 cancelled. And this minus, this plus cancelled. That means what is the result? 0. So your A is the right answer. I think that you understood how to solve this type of a question if it is given. So again tomorrow I come up with a new lesson. Till then, have a nice day and thanks for watching this lesson.